One of the long-standing debates in public policy centers on the relationship between minimum wage laws and the unemployment rate. On one side, opponents of government intervention in the economy have argued that higher minimum wages increase the unemployment rate because they make it more expensive to employ workers. In the context of higher wages, businesses will be forced to hire fewer workers. On the other side, advocates for higher minimum wages argue that higher wages leave the workers with more money to spend, boosting consumption and growth, thereby increasing employment opportunities for workers in a virtuous cycle. So who's right? Do minimum wages increase or decrease the unemployment rate? Hey everyone, I'm Noah Zerbe. I'm a professor of political economy at Humboldt State University. In this video series, I try to explain the theories and concepts behind current events, all in 2 minutes or less. The relationship between minimum wages and unemployment rates has been at the center of political debate for decades, but the winners of this year's Nobel Prize in Economics may have answered the question once and for all. David Card, an economist at the University of California, Berkeley, looked at the impact of minimum wage increases in New Jersey in the early 1990s and compared it with Pennsylvania, which did not increase its minimum wage. This resulted in a natural experiment between the two case studies. Card looks specifically at the employment in fast food restaurants, which employ a large number of minimum wage workers. The two cases, Pennsylvania and New Jersey, were similar in a number of important respects. They were neighbors, they had similar labor markets, and with the exception of the change in the minimum wage, they looked really similar. So what were the results of Card's study? Relative to Pennsylvania, Card found that employment in New Jersey's fast food restaurants increased by about 13% after the introduction of a higher minimum wage. Increasing the minimum wage, it turned out, generated more spending and economic activity on the part of the workers, thereby creating new jobs and reducing the rate of unemployment, according to Card. Initially, there was considerable pushback against Card's findings. In some ways, his findings represented a rejection of the central law of economics, that is, that there's an inverse relationship between price and demand, or that as the price of something increases, demand for that thing will decline. But over time, Card's findings were gradually embraced in much of the economics literature, and his methodology of finding natural experiments became increasingly commonplace in the field. And so in 2021, Card was awarded the Nobel Prize in Economics for his contributions to labor economics and for his work in developing the methodology of natural experiments in the social sciences. That's it for now. I hope you found this informative. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below. And if you found it helpful, click the thumbs up button and consider subscribing to get notified as I release future explainers. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a good day.